capable of doing that. So as far as I'm concerned, I've known to be a person of action. So whatever I say, I believe in. And if I take a stand on one side, I generally do and I stand by it. So as far as I'm concerned, you know, I was like, I'll give you a little interesting story that's now it came up that like a Christian, I was going to be thrown to the lions till you whispered something in the lion's ear and the lion ran away. And everybody asked me, what did you say? I said, if you eat me, you'll have to go and speak in this debate. Anyway, that's having said that now, let me now get on to a situation what I mean by coalition. Coalition of dependence is what you have to avoid. What is happening in MP today is that you have the Congress with 114 seats and one seat of SP and one seat of BSP. That is the worst kind of coalition because you're depending on two individuals for your government to stay in power. A coalition of the same ideology, whether it's Shiv Sena or whether it's BJP or whether it's X, is not a coalition in my mind. So when I say that for the future of India, as everybody has said, the growth story, it depends on the fact that we do not ever have a coalition of dependence. It is not the numbers that matter. It is not the question of one or two. Vajpayee's government came down because of one person. Again, there was utter chaos when CPM withdrew its support from the Congress and they didn't know what to do at that point of time till Mulayam Singh Yadav came along and supported that government. So if you have different ideologies together and if you think you are forming, then you get into what Arifji was saying. It becomes a question of how to stay in power. It is not a question of moving in one direction. Of course, one makes mistakes in any coalition. Today, Raghav is here and I was reading your budget your government was presenting. In spite of not getting statehood, in spite of not getting done, we've done all this. Can you imagine if they were running a coalition? What would have happened to them if they had five other parties? In spite of them having this, they've got into a problem. So what I'm trying to say is avoid coalition of dependence always in your life. That is what I'm standing for. And economic growth means what? I'm talking about economic growth for India for the next 10 years. Why do you need one particular party? Vote for BJP, vote for Congress, vote for whoever you like. But stability will only come about when you have a coalition which does not depend on any other party for power. That's the most important. Of course, everybody will live in India with coalition. Who's going to argue with a simple argument like that? But do we need that kind of coalition or do you need what this Gathbandhan is, where Mamata is screaming and Mayawati wants something else, Samajwadi wants something else? Then you have a complete khichdi which you have spoken about, which has to be avoided at all costs because the khichdi is going to go out of your hand in a matter of 6 months or 12 months if you have different ideologies together. By all means, let Congress get all its parties together. Get them form a government with the same kind of ideology, it's fine. But if you're singing, I'm bringing in because I want to remove one man. I want to remove one party. We'll all get together. We'll win. And if we win, then we'll decide where we go. That will never last as far as we are concerned. And let me bring in a little bit of the corporate world. For whatever its world, everybody's going to attack. Running a country is not the same as running a company. But you take Microsoft. Windows never agreed. As far as even Microsoft is concerned, you got Windows Alphabet, you got Windows, and you got X. Microsoft said, if you form a coalition of everybody, you're going to get nowhere. So you have to let in your own system work well under the complete control of Microsoft. Then the company moves forward. That's the way the country will move forward. So if you have a coalition today, whether it is of ideological parties which are all working, let that government run it like a coalition in spite of being the most powerful party. Everybody will have to listen to that party to do it. And that's exactly what I'm trying to say right from the beginning. And I want to end my speech on that because the other side of having coalition is that you tend to become a controller because to stay in power, you do not become someone who's an enabler. Vote for a government that enables the country to move forward, get down to the poorest, but you got to have growth, otherwise it's not going to happen. Thank you.
Questions for Sunil Alagh? You all are giving him a very easy time.
Very easy to do whatever.
You know why there are no questions for him? Because he said, we agree coalition has to be there. It's a kind of coalition that is important. Yes, so he's basically been batting from our side. I mean, thank you very much, Sunil. Thank you very much.
But it's not necessarily for us, because currently the NDA government is a coalition in that sense.
Yeah. So basically,
it's not for us.
No. Since he was arguing that you have to take a position, he took a position and he said coalition is good. That's it. He agreed with us. I mean, why Alagh Alagh? Come here.
No. I just want to say there are... No. That's okay. Yeah, what I want to end, there are three kinds of things I've learned in my life which you must have. One is the wishbone, one is the backbone, and the other is the funny bone. If you don't have any of these three, you're gone, regardless of whatever government is, regardless of the debate. Thank you very much.
Deepak, this debate, we're going to rearrange all the chairs.
No, sir, your power is cut.
Hello. Ji. Sir, now we are living in times which are very different from the times when there were political ideologies. And it is, I'm not just talking about India, the world over. When Neil Kinnock was leader of the Labour Party and he released the manifesto of the Labour Party, then the media asked this question, that the manifesto of the Tories and the Labour, there is hardly any difference. Neil Kinnock, he responded by saying, but we will manage it better. So sir, it's now more, is it question of ideologies or question of credibility? Whether you stand by what you have committed to the voters, to the electorate. What in your view is the main question?
Sir, actually, because we are a democracy, whatever you commit to the people, you are gauged in the next elections based on whether you've achieved it or not. If you are a dictatorship, you can keep on committing and you can carry on because there are no elections. So as far as even Obama, that yes we can, he didn't do in the first 4 years. Yes we can happened in the next 4 years. Please, I will tell you, therefore, no. Your question is, therefore, the commitment that you make to the public, whether it's going to take 4 years or 8 years, you should tell them that in the beginning. And as far as I'm concerned, I don't like to debate with somebody on my side. It's no point. You know, I've written one aapke liye sirf. Arif ji, ye maine likhe aapke liye main leke aaya hu. मैं किसको इल्जाम दूं? यहां तो सताने वाले भी अपने हैं और दफनाने वाले भी अपने हैं. ये आपके लिए मारुति लिख के आया.
थैंक यू मिस्टर अलागह. संजय झा, व्हाई डोंट यू गो अहेड एंड स्पीक. आई एम कंफ्यूज्ड विद योर फॉर अगेंस्ट द मोशन, बट जस्ट